Watch the puddles gather rain. It's raining. It's Thursday. It's the 10th of December. And by Jove, it's raining. Thank goodness. Wherever you may be, please stop and please stand. It's 8:01 a.m. Let's rise together for this morning's Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. It's also Thinking Thursday. And on this Thinking Thursday, I got to tell you what I'm thinking about, because there's been all this discussion and talk about COVID-19 and the potential for this vaccine. And I got to tell you, when the vaccine is ready and it's been safely tested and the scientists say, look, it's time, it's go time, the vaccine's here, I'm interested. I'm going to be taking it. But it also has me thinking that they've got to transport this vaccine, and they're saying it's got to be kept at 94 degrees Fahrenheit. Negative 94 degrees Fahrenheit. None of us, to my knowledge, have ever experienced as people, none of us have experienced this temperature and what that does to you and how quickly things freeze at 94 degrees Fahrenheit. So, got me thinking. First of all, at what point, is this vaccine frozen at 94, or is it just slowed down, and that's what helps preserve it until the point of entering into giving the injection? And if it's not frozen, then it's liquid. If it's negative 94 degrees, you can't put that into your body. That can't make any sense. So when you thaw it out or warm it up, how warm can it be? That's one of my questions, is what temperature is appropriate to keep this at once it's rewarmed? And then once it's rewarmed, for how long can you keep it at that temperature before it is no longer a viable vaccine? In addition to that, this got me thinking, negative 94 degrees, that's so stinking cold. Like, your eyeballs would freeze shut if you went outside and it was negative 94 degrees. So that's really cold. So I'm wondering also, though, how did scientists figure out that negative 94 degrees Fahrenheit was the temperature that would work, would keep this vaccine viable? I mean, did they try it out and said, ooh, negative 93 was not quite enough. Negative 95 was too much. But negative 94 was the sweet spot. How'd they figure that out? I don't know, but it's got me thinking on this Thinking Thursday. And now, this. 30 seconds of the sound of rain. On this Thursday, as we continue PBIS, our goal this week has been to be caring and using kind words and faces, because we're spending all our time in each other's faces on our computers. Well, for Thursday, we are encouraging you to make sure your words are helpful. Chat can be distracting, and it can take away from the learning if it's used in the wrong way. For example, if you just spam by hitting a bunch of letters or just leaning on a key with your elbow, just waste a bunch of time. It doesn't help you learn, and we've got a lot to learn. So that's your tip for today, PBIS. We appreciate you helping keep our school culture strong and your classroom culture strong as well. Now some words of wisdom so you can get to the business of teaching and learning. Today is on the topic of choices, making choices. Have you ever made the choice not to do your homework or your asynchronous work? And then when it was time to turn it in, you suddenly wished you'd made a wiser choice. It's an interesting thing about choices. They all come with a consequence, good or bad. American evangelist Dr. Billy Graham once said, "We make our own choices and we pay the price for those choices." This week, and the rest of this week, be aware of the dozens of choices you make every day and think about the consequences of those choices. Notice how good behavior brings you good results and bad behavior brings bad results. Take a look at how good study habits bring better grades, while poor study habits can bring poor grades. Remember, all our choices come with a consequence. It's a simple formula, with predictable results. It's something to think about. This is Mr. Lodato. Make it a great day or not. The choice is yours.